ward safety. Healthcare professionals are potentially exposed to infectious materials such as blood, tissue, body fluids, or equipments and work surfaces contaminated with these substances. Exposure can occur due to needle stick injury or cut with sharps. Contact of mucous membrane of eyes or mouth by infected material. As per the WHO guidelines, there are 10 standard precautions for infection control. These are meant to reduce the risk of transmission of blood-borne and other pathogens from both recognized and unrecognized sources. These include hand hygiene, gloves, facial protection, gown. All three come under personal protective equipment. Prevention of needle stick injuries, respiratory hygiene and cough etiquettes, environmental cleaning, linens, waste disposal, and patient care equipment. It is important for all the health workers to follow these standard safety precautions. Let us begin with. First, hand hygiene. Most important means of preventing and controlling spread of infection is hand hygiene. Follow WHO recommended 6 steps of hand washing as shown later. Or hand rub using alcohol or chlorhexidine. 5 moments of hand hygiene by WHO. Before touching a patient, before clean or aseptic procedures, after body fluid exposure, after touching a patient, and after touching patient surroundings. 6 steps to hand washing. 1. Rub palms together. 2. Rub palms along with interlacing fingers. 3. Rub right palm over left dorsum with interlacing of fingers and vice versa. 4. Interlock fingers and rub back of the fingers. 5. Rotational rubbing of right thumb clasped in left palm and vice versa. 6. Rotational rubbing back and forth of left fingertips and thumbnails on right palm and vice versa. Use of personal protective equipment. All blood and body fluids are potentially infectious and precautions are necessary to prevent exposure to them. All procedures, including sample collection, should be done wearing gloves and apron and following hand hygiene. All skin lesions, for example, cuts, scratches, dermatitis, or other breaks, should be covered with waterproof bandage. Take care to avoid contaminating hands during collection of blood. Well-fitting disposable gloves to be used and should be changed if visibly contaminated with blood. Remove gloves before handling doorknobs, telephones, pens, and performing office work. Immunization. Immunization against preventable infections like hepatitis B immunization should be done for all those working in healthcare facilities and especially for phlebotomists. 3-dose immunization should be given, followed by testing for antibodies after 1 to 2 months. The concentration of antibodies to hepatitis B surface antigen should be more than 10 international units per ml. If the levels are less than 10 international units per ml, a 4th dose is to be given and confirmed by testing for the antibodies once again. Safe disposal of sharps and infectious waste. Needle stick injuries in healthcare workers is a common occurrence in wards or ICUs where staff is most at risk after withdrawing blood at the bedside and transferring the used needle for for sharp disposal. It is during this transfer of naked needle from the bedside to the disposal site that the healthcare worker puts herself and other workers at the risk of needle stick injuries. This dangerous practice can be easily substituted by simple yet effective practices that ensure safety from needle stick injuries. Organize equipment at the point of use. A phlebotomy tray is a simple solution which eliminates the need of going back and forth for equipment and consumables needed for the procedure, and also transferring used needle to the discard site. It is simply a metal or a plastic tray stocked with all equipment and consumables needed for phlebotomy, namely needles, syringes, sterile cotton swabs, spirit, gloves, tunicae, various vacutainers or tubes for collecting blood. A few blood culture bottles can also be kept. An important component can be a portable mechanical needle cutter, which ensures the cutting of the needle at the bedside and eliminates dangerous practice of recapping or transfer of naked needles in hand. It consists of a sharp blade on the top, which can be exposed when the needle needs to be cut. The needle can be cut by pressing the two arms of the cutter together. Expose the blade and insert the needle into the hole. Press the two arms together. The needle is cut at the hub. The remaining syringe and hub can be discarded according to the biomedical waste rules. Always keep sufficient stock needed for the day and do not forget to replenish the used material for the next day. Make sure that the tray is clean. To make the discard of used material easier and effective, a trolley, if available, can be dedicated to phlebotomy. The upper section can be used for placing the phlebotomy tray, while the lower section can be used to keep waste bins with different color-coded bags and discard container for shops. Management of needle stick injury. The same procedure to be followed as explained in the phlebotomy section. Spill management. In case of spill, the spill management should be followed as explained in the phlebotomy section. Routine decontamination of instruments and exposed surfaces. Tourniquets are a potential source of methicillin-resistant Staphylococcus aureus, also known as MRSA. With up to 25% of tourniquets contaminated through lack of hand hygiene on part of the phlebotomist, this can be prevented by following hand hygiene diligently. Reusable finger prick devices and related point-of-care testing devices, for example glucometers, contaminated with blood have been implicated in outbreaks of hepatitis B. To prevent contamination, all common use items like glucometers should be visibly cleaned before use on a patient, and a single-use item should not be reused.